Make sure to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this.
Do you plan ahead? Is that what windchill sub-zero up there in northern Minnesota?
That's a little much.
Yeah,
that's a little much.
Somewhere in between, Alex. Well, yesterday we asked you, how do you plan ahead for a week of weather? Do you plan ahead? Do you check the weather on a daily basis, hourly, or are you just like wing it? So we had a great set of comments coming in. This first one from Mark, who said, definitely look at the weather and plan our week accordingly. Look at which days are going to be the best and drive to different places, and which days are better to just stay at home and work on indoor projects.
Wow, that's a planner.
That's a planner, but also nice options there.
Exactly. Kathy said, I don't plan my week ahead of time. The weather seems to always change. I pick my clothes day by day based on the weather.
I do actually look at the week ahead and try to plan, like, which day I'm going to wear short sleeves versus long sleeves or boots weather. You know what I mean? I totally do that.
Kind of just give it a little scan and say, okay, maybe I can do this. Yeah. Maybe you always have the option to change up if the forecast changes, which I'm sure happens all the time.
All right. Now, the sounds of the season help get you into the holiday spirit. And Mother Nature, thank you. We're going to keep checking back in with you. There is another shot of snow coming into the Northeast, a chance of it anyway. So I want to show you where that comes from. Let's look at the forecast. We do have about an inch, maybe even two or three in a number of spots here throughout the Northeast. Now you can see it's not just lake effect. This next time we've got parts of Vermont, New Hampshire, up into Maine, maybe even Boston with the chance of snow. Next disturbance comes in. You see it right there across portions of the upper plains. And then we watch that move east, tracking here over the Great Lakes, maybe bringing some light precip there. Then it heads into the Northeast. And what's most important that happens with this is what happens over the ocean, actually. We get a coastal low. Where exactly does that form? And then how much moisture does it throw back, and does it meet up with the cold air? That's the dance that the atmosphere is trying to put together for you here. And so this is tomorrow. We start with some snow showers out there. You'll see that maybe across central New York, Albany, the Capital District, Binghamton, Buffalo, Syracuse, all have some snow chances, but not like the kind of snow that Mike is getting, right? It's not going to be that big dump of the lake effect at this point with system snow. Now, here we go in Boston tomorrow afternoon. We're waiting for that coastal low to start forming. We have a chance of getting into some snow at this point, continuing into the evening. Again, the questions here are how much moisture gets back into the system? How quickly does this move out, right? Do you only get an hour or two of this, or do you get a couple of hours? So we do bring in some snow chances for places like Boston, but it's about an inch right now in the forecast. We haven't hit anything yet this year. Boston, again, an inch in our forecast all across the metro area. But you need to know this, that our forecast is an inch. But when you look at, you sort of, what are the odds? What are the probabilities? It's possible that we get an inch. It's much more likely that we only get about a trace to nothing. And so that's important to know in this forecast. There's a chance of that, but not much more, Alex.
Indeed, indeed. The most widespread snow that we have seen this season.
This is going to be the first snowstorm for a lot of you. So we'll get to all of that. We've got a lot going on today. Mentioned the fact that we are going to talk about winter blues or seasonal affective disorder. And we've got some great tips, actually, to help people get through this time of year, which, you know, can be tough, actually, mentally.
Yeah.
When you have that lack of daylight.
Yeah, I mean, let's think about it. Just on a normal basis, you go two or three days in clouds and rain. Yeah. You just kind of feel, ugh.
And then the sun setting at 4 o'clock doesn't help, right? Mm-hmm. All right, well, today we do have some snow showers out there. They're few and far between, but it was probably pretty exciting when you looked out the window this morning in Cincinnati. You got your first snowflakes of the season, a little bit probably accumulated on your maybe back deck. Now this is moving through the Northeast, and we'll talk about just how much is coming out of the system there.
A little bit more rain across parts of the South and the East. Meanwhile, we head to the West Coast where we're finding a few more showers, but really things are going to start to organize a bit more as we head towards that end of the week, moving out of the Rockies and through the middle of the nation as we head on through the next couple of days. And get those temperatures, keeping it on the cooler side, the northern tier, but southern tier, Jen, staying on the warm side.
And getting warmer. Now, yesterday, we asked you, what did you think is the most festive holiday city? And your responses were amazing. We love them. We've gotten so many ideas out of them. So we're going to give you some forecasts for some of your answers.
All right. Well, here's Michelle, who says, my town has a winter celebration of lights. East Peoria, that is pretty popular. Tour buses come through all month. and sometimes really mess up traffic for us locals, but got to take the bad with the good, I suppose.
Yes, for sure. That always happens around some of the best light displays, right? We also got a lot of votes for Frankenmuth, Michigan. This is north of Flint. Mm-hmm. Got the radar up here for you. It's just south of Saginaw. Now, it's known for its Bavarian-style architecture, much like Helen, Georgia, that we showed you yesterday. Little snow coming in right now, kind of putting a little sugar coating out there on the displays.
Hey. In a festive mood, yes. And the forecast does call for that to come to an end. Heads up, though, heading into the end of the week, rain for you at least Friday afternoon. Weekend, though, not too bad outside of a windy start to it on Saturday.
They have, like, the European Christmas markets here. And from what I understand, it's, like, pretty much legit, like what you get, you know, over in Germany
like
is what you see
get
here. Yes.
Okay, pretty cool.
So, yeah, right. Check it out.
All right, well, the sun not necessarily setting on the snow and rain coming to town in today's big deal. Showers shining down on much of the south. A few rumbles of thunder also whirling
west. Let's look at that because things are going to be changing, actually, in the coming days. You're a lot different than weather you've seen in months, really, into parts of the west. Look at the forecast for snowfall. You know, not just in Washington and Oregon, which we have seen some lately, but you look at the Sierra finally getting back into a snowfall forecast. The Wasatch in Utah, the Colorado Rockies, the Rockies in Wyoming. I mean, look at the mountain ranges that are going to be picking up more than a foot of snowfall. Ski resorts are rejoicing over this. We have temperatures that are going to be cooling down enough to get us a snowfall. Not super cold, but cold enough. And then we've got the winter weather advisories and winter storm watches that are up. So let's time out this first system that is coming in. We're seeing signs of it already today into the northwest, but it does actually move south. And you're going to see this arc of moisture coming in over the Pacific. It moves all the way down into portions of Central California. You'll see the Sierra getting into some new snow that comes in for you Thursday into early Friday. Then all of that shifts over here Friday into Colorado, into Utah, and we'll be getting more snow out of that. So we are at 19%, 19.7, let's round up to 20% snow cover right now. We added a little bit yesterday, actually, into parts of Wisconsin and southeast Minnesota, but really this is below where we normally are when you look back at the past 10, 15 years or so at this point in the season. So we'll be adding to it. The big question is Denver, do we get snow on Friday? It is possible, Alex. It's still not a guarantee, but it definitely, you know, there's a decent chance we get an inch. And that would end up tying our longest streak without snow.
No, we don't want time.